And now here's a look at the biggest corporate stories this afternoon, starting with the country's flag carrier, Philippine Airlines. It reports its net income for the first three quarters of the year. It reached 19.2 billion pesos. That figure represents more than two-fold increase compared to last year's net income. PAL also assures the public it is ready to face the possible increase in fuel prices due to geopolitical conflicts. Meanwhile, the Lopez Group's clean and renewable energy provider, First Gen Corporation, ended a nine-month period with a net income of 13.8 billion pesos, up 28% than what was recorded last year. The firm attributes this increase to higher interest income due to high yields from its internally generated cash. As for Tycoon Dennis Uy's telco firm, Converge ICT, it posted a slight dip in third quarter bottom line at 2.08 billion pesos. However, its nine-month net income increased by 4% year-on-year. The firm also surpassed a 2 million subscriber milestone by continuing growth across all packages. And finally, Nickel Asia Corporation says its net income for the nine-month period slumped 47% to 3.6 billion pesos. This is on the back of lower nickel ore prices due to the increase in Indonesian nickel production. The Philippine Trade Department teams up with local government units for the integration of the business name registration system. Let's learn more about this scheme from our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Jackie, go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. Eight more local government units, or LGUs, have agreed to integrate their system into the business name registration system next generation of the Department of Trade and Industry. This brings to 10 the total number of LGUs linked to the system, with more expecting to come on board in the coming months. At a signing ceremony in Makati, Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual thanked the eight LGUs, which accepted their offer for system integration. He said this will help speed up the application of business permits at the local level. One requirement usually for a business permit at the LGU is the DTI Certificate of Business Name Registration, which would take usually additional time to get. LGUs then would have to check the authenticity of the certificate, making the application process longer. But Pascual said now, if the system is integrated with DTI, then there is no more need to submit or to print a hard copy of the DTI certificate. The eight LGUs are Bislig in Surigao del Sur, Butuan in Agusan del Norte, Balanga in Bataan, Bacolod City, Iginto in Bulacan, Baguio City, San Pedro Laguna, and Carmona in Cavite. Parañaque and Quezon City were the first two to integrate with the system earlier. Pascual noted that this will help entice Filipinos to register their business name and apply for a business permit. Meanwhile, DTI has also signed the Implementing Rules and Regulations, or the IRR, of the One Town, One Product Philippines Act. The law was earlier signed by President Marcos last August, and it aims to help micro, small, and medium-scale enterprises, as well as enable communities to determine, develop, and promote products and services rooted in their area. And that's the latest. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks, Jackie. Portabia, Ireland's food board, has embarked on a trade mission to Southeast Asia with a focus on major markets in the Philippines and Malaysia. The mission aims to bolster Ireland's reputation as a provider of safe and high-quality food. The European country will also share its expertise and experiences in agriculture and food production. In the Philippines, the primary Irish exports include dairy, beef, drinks, sheep meat, and seafood. In 2022, Irish exports to Southeast Asia were valued at an estimated 394 million euros, or around 23.5 billion pesos.
I think all business is built around people, and certainly from the few days that we've spent here in Manila, we have a growing population of Filipino people in Ireland. So we know the Filipino people, and it's we've received a very warm welcome. So it's easy to do business in this environment, and we believe we've got great products to bring to the market. And from the reaction that we've had and the growth in exports in the the last number of years. I think we're happy to say that the Filipino people agree with us, and we hope that we can do more business together in the years ahead. We're very good, as the minister said, at growing grass. So our dairy and our beef, we export 90% of what we produce. We have far more food in Ireland than we can consume ourselves. We export to 180 countries around the world. So for us to come to Southeast Asia is actually something that is perfectly normal.
Inclusiveness is key to achieving sustainable economic growth. That's according to the International Finance Corporation, the private sector arm of the World Bank Group. Its regional VP for Asia and Pacific told ANC, "The Philippines is on the right track in terms of policy making and adopting strategies to make the economy more resilient to harsher climate patterns."
And I can see, from the very small companies to the big companies, a great concern about all the aspects of a green economy. And I see a country that can attract a lot of private financing to help in this endeavor. The Philippine government is doing very well. It's very, very clear what is the way forward and how to achieve the needed results in terms of mitigation and in terms of what you rightly said, adaptation. How is the Philippines going to adapt to a climate which is going to be harsher than in the past? And I think the right policies are in place. I also think that most of the private companies here in the Philippines have clear plans on how they're going to adapt their assets to a new climate pattern.
Meta Platforms has struck a deal with Tencent Holdings to sell a new low-cost virtual reality headset in China. According to a report by the Wall Street Journal, the preliminary deal will make Tencent the exclusive seller of Meta's headsets in China, adding the Chinese video game maker will start selling the headsets in late 2024. The VR deal gives Meta a chance to return to the Chinese market and compete with TikTok owner ByteDance. Facebook and Instagram have been blocked by Beijing since mid-2009, following deadly riots in Xinjiang province, which authorities blamed on social networking sites.